Monster Cup 5. My name is Nimsh, and I'm here with Strive Crew and Thais. And this is a very interesting moment because I think the guys never casted together.
No. I don't believe so.
We just pointed it out. Like, we have live casted quite some everywhere, but never together, Strive.
Yeah. I know me and Marcy cast a lot together. Oh, yeah. Back in the old days.
Back in the day,
Some nostalgia going on here.
And I casted a lot of Thais as well. Oh, so. Mm-hmm. We did cast together a lot, so I hope our free caster duo,
Synergy,
like trio, definitely will work together well.
I'll be Dr. Boom. You be my right boom bot, your left boom bot.
Oh, dude. So I am Dr. Boom.
Fine. I'll be the right boom bot.
Okay.
I like right boom bot.
Boom bot's got nerfed, kind of. Okay. Out of the center.
Oh, okay.
All right, but the big thing is actually the players will have Firebird versus Forsen elimination match. So why not those guys is going home or like just staying and having fun here at Story Cup?
Yeah. Watch both their matches. They're both pretty sweet, so I want to see this. Yeah.
Also, pretty powerful. The Druids are doing really good, like everywhere today. Like yesterday, it was really the Zeus performing well, but today it's really the day of the Druid. Like in a lot of groups, Druid is the deck that is performing the best, I feel.
Even on the secondary stream, actually, the Druid is the key deck, right?
I actually casted Hoyes against Naaman, and Naaman was drawing three aggro decks against Yogg-Druid. Got 3-0'd.
Oh, well, and just what just happened was also in reverse sweep, like 2-0 behind, also 3-0 off stream.
Nice.
There, like, so it's doing really well now.
Really powerful, really powerful deck. And how are you guys having fun? Like, I know, like, Thais, you've been on this couch many times, but Strive Crew, are you having fun at this tournament? They got eliminated, one, but still, you know, there's a lot of stuff you can do here.
I mean, I spent like 3 or 4 hours today playing Overwatch in a row. I was like on a huge spree, but
nice.
I need to take a break from that.
Yeah, it makes sense. Like, talk some Hearthstone.
Yeah, it's fun learning to play on new equipment.
Yeah, exactly. Every time
you drop like 6 ranks. But, you know, you can get them back.
Absolutely, yeah. All right. I want to talk about to you guys about the sponsors as well and our raffle, because we do have a raffle for you. So let's go to our Facebook page. The Facebook page, which is Take TV. This is the site. And you can click on SSC5 raffle to actually access the raffle. Just enter your details. You can win some really cool stuff in here. This is stuff you can win.
Ooh, and the chair is really comfortable.
Yeah, the chair is really comfy. And you're using the G2 one, right?
Yeah, it's amazing. Need for Seat, really good chairs.
And if you have Need for Seat, this is one of our sponsors, Need for Seat, here are the chairs. You can buy on their site. One of the chairs you can win in the raffle as well. And our sponsor is Logitech. Logitech doing some good stuff. And I believe, Striker, you're using Logitech gear.
Yeah, I also have the C9 seat.
Nice.
So, we all have the seat.
So there is a Strive Crew seal of approval on this gear.
Yeah.
It's your full equipment, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really good equipment there. And obviously, also Sennheiser. One of our sponsors here for this event, bringing the Egyptian theme of Seat Story Cup, doing some really good headsets. And last but not least is Matcherino. Matcherino, guys, where you can donate money to increase the prize pool of the event. And also, it's just really simple. Just sign in with your Twitch account. You can donate stuff. There was the code Seat Story. Not sure if it still works, but it was a free dollar to add to the pool. And there are some stretch goals as well. And the stretch goals are Reynard versus Forsen, for example. So if we reach a stretch goal, Reynard versus Forsen will play on stream. It's not a boxing match, I believe. It's a Hearthstone match, but
I think we'd get more money if it was a boxing match. Actually, it'd be way more, right?
Yeah.
Probably, yes.
Yeah, we can maybe set that.
maybe that's even a third stretch goal.
Okay.
That'll be fun. All right, but Firebat versus Forsen is going to be the match, and I think they're starting right now. What do you guys think? Who has an edge?
I believe Firebat for me. Okay. I'm cheering for my boys.
Because Cloud9?
C9. Okay. Yeah.
Okay, well, then I pick Forsen.
Okay.
I know Forsen. I trust him in his lineup. Firing a lot of shots to him, but I know he's going to do it here.
All right. So
things started.
They started with Zul versus Druid, and this is a very interesting matchup because we seem to not agree exactly who has an edge here, who doesn't.
Everyone thinks differently because... Yeah.
We just added about this matchup, like the people are really figuring out how this matchup is.
I think a lot of it is like Zul has always beaten Druid, like this is like always before. I think this is the first like standard Druid that's maybe like be a favorite against Zoot. In my opinion, this is like 55% for Druid.
Why is that? Can you explain?
So I think it's just because Zoot has gotten weaker with the removal of like Egg and Haunted Creeper. Druid here, I think it's just the combos. It's just with the addition of
Living
Roots?
What's
it called? It is Living Roots. Raven Idol as well.
Yeah, Raven Idol.
You just have so much more removal because Raven Idol, you have a lot of good discovers and you can just clear Zoo so much now.
Also, this kind of like Druid deck, it has like the teacher. Like, yeah. But it's like a bit more mm-hmm. you can use as an anti-aggro, and with the Living Roots, the Wild Growth, even the Keeper, like you got a lot bit of more options. Zoo not having like an implosion anymore might be like hurting a little that they can't react in that 3 or 4 drop so well.
Actually, I think another thing is Yogg is a powerhouse in this matchup, because if you think about what Yogg usually does, clears the board, draws cards, things like that, maybe play some secrets. That's mm-hmm. exactly what you want against Zoo, you know, turn 10.
Sure.
If you can survive, you could almost always make a comeback.
But what I also feel as a really power card as the Zoo player, or like what I always face as the Druid, oh, please just don't have that power overwhelming. I'm always at a spot there, I'm like, okay, if they just don't have the power overwhelming, I think this game can go really well.
They always have the
power. But
yeah, they always have the power overwhelming. From my perspective, I honestly think that Zoo is favorite in this matchup still, because Zoo has really consistent draws and really consistent plan where you just want to play minions and go face and kill the Druid, where Druid really needs to hit those cards. Like you said, a really good discovers, they are obviously a possibility. Like sometimes Starfall can just win you the game, or like a really good Wrath in the beginning. But most of the time, from my experience, if I'm playing Zoo, I just kill the Druid before anything happens. And sometimes when I play the Druid, also it's really hard to come back, but there are ways, obviously. So maybe closer to 50-50.
Yeah, well, this is a crazy hand for Forsen. Yeah. He has both swipes and the ramp, right? He has turn 2 already, Wild Growth. Turn 3, gonna ramp to 6 mana.
I still think this ramp is really appealing. Like, swipe is the power card against Zoo. I don't think it's that appealing here. It kills a Flame
Imp. Only one minion here.
Exactly. And ramp is just still really good. Like, it looks not that appealing maybe because you want to fight already against Zoo, but with the swipe, this my keeper is going to trade with one minion.
Yeah, exactly.
In worst case, you face an abusive that also dies for free to swipe, but it's still really nice.
And you want to also ramp, like, to have more possibilities in the future to play maybe Ancient of War and even, like, if you want to draw.
Oh, no, I will never
pick this.
Never.
No. I think that has to be wrong.
Yeah.
Even next turn, just, like, immediately next turn, you get another value from your hero power, or even if you want a Wild Growth.
You
right?
just, so, well, instead of, like, gaining a coin every turn, like, you gain a coin every turn.
Yeah.
Every turn, here's a coin for you. Like, and now you gain a 2-1 that just dies on board to the Squire.
Yeah, for like 6 turns, right?
And next turn, indeed, like, instead of swipe Hero Power, swipe Wild Growth, you're gonna do it with the empty swipe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I agree that Crystal was there as a
keeper. I mean, the thing about this is you do get 2 minions, so it trades for another minion. But the thing is, since if you ramp to 6, you have the, if you're gonna swipe, you have the extra Hero Power anyways mm-hmm. to kill the Flame Imp, or, you know.
It's already painful here because now it would have been on board clear. Like, no, the Flame Imp would have been survived. So you straight, it would only leave then a 1-1 up.
Yeah. Well,
so I still think swipe is a power card. Like, if you don't have to swipe, I would still not swipe here. You can still Wild Growth and just swipes are gonna be always good later, right?
Yeah, especially because there's also Forbidden Ritual. But Firebat's hand is not the best actually with those two POs now. He had to tap last turn to be able to get some cards.
But I guess with the abusive Voidwalker, tapping is still fine. At least the curve is not too horrible. Doesn't put too much pressure on. Would have loved to drop the Consummon before.
It doesn't seem like Firebat does have 2 POs, but Yogg is pretty close.
Yeah. Yogg as well. It's not that
surprisingly,
close.
Surprisingly, not that close.
Yeah. If it would have been one more ramp, it could have been closer soon. Using second swipe can really hurt you now.
Yeah.
Like, instantly Forbidden Ritual afterwards and you already regret it, I feel.
Yeah, this
but
is why
there is the
swipe
Raven
last
Idol.
Turn. This is why the swipe last turn, I think, was not the right play. Because now, like, you always want to have at least one backup plan, right? So if you use that swipe last turn, you feel really bad using this swipe now.
Oh, man.
Yeah, he's going for the swipe, so he feels like maybe there's no Forbidden Ritual. And there is no ritual,
well,
actually.
There is a Raven Idol to pick up a Starfall, to pick up a swipe. Like, it gives you a lot of more options to get something.
True.
And,
Sometimes
it's really good against the Zoo to be either playing, like, keep playing minions so they lose their power overwhelming and it is, like, really not likely they have more, or just keep reacting with spells. So they only have to play their minions and cannot use their power buffs.
That was an amazing pickup by Forsen, because Ancient of War here is 100% going to buy him enough time for Yogg now, right? There's like no...
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, like there's especially because no he also has small to like remove.
How much spells have they been played? Like, was it that much?
That's
I saw
important.
Double swipe, right?
I believe there have been around 7 spells right
already?
Now.
Already?
No. Two... Two,
two
Walgross, Raven Idol.
Oh yeah, it's true.
No Innervates. Maybe 5 actually.
5? Yeah, okay.
No Roots.
If some of these gets played though.
No problem, man. The Voidwalker deals with the war.
A 10-12 Voidwalker.
10-12 Voidwalker. Just a one drop, guys. Just.
Yeah, but now Forsen has the Melch deal with the first. Ooh. Oh wow, another power card.
Yeah, that's
well,
that's good.
You don't have to draw scenarios before turn 9. So.
Yeah, Zoo has a very hard time dealing damage from their hand, so you can reasonably expect the 2-2 to taunt out the Councilman this turn.
Unless there is a Soulfire from Peddler.
Yeah.
Ooh.
So.
Soulfire is good. Corruption is very good as well here.
Yeah, Corruption will deal with scenarios. Yeah. Soulfire will allow you to attack face with the...
It's like a Village Squire and a Mortal Call here. Nothing really does any impact on the board directly here. Mortal Call, nothing he can do it with. He first has to pass the taunts.
I think it's the best card to have in your hand, though, because
these
two cards are so low impact, you'd rather just, if you can cycle that Mortal Coil into a high impact card like Doomguard.
What does he want to do with the curve? Just probably playing Imp Gang Boss?
I think Imp Gang Boss and just trade. Yeah. It's too ambitious to go for the Peddler here, right?
Yeah, you want to kind of like build up your board again. And you've seen double swipe, so you feel good about it.
Yeah.
You don't know what the card. Is from Raven Idol in Forsen's hand, but...
I would definitely not Yogg here.
No, but the Mark of Nature is so good here. Like, giving taunt to scenarios, making it a 5-12. Like, it's just super good.
You can even go face, right? Start dealing that damage.
Yeah, I don't mind it, actually.
I would go face here.
Yeah.
You kill one minion, Sir Darwolf
double PO is gone.
Mm-hmm. I feel like if you trade for Imp Gang, trading for Imp Gang here is actually worse than trading for the 2-2, in my opinion. Oh. Because you're not killing the minion, right? So there's
another
5-10,
another Ancient of War on the board, guys. Oh wow! Oh, gets the Void Terror here, Firebat. Can he do something?
Wait, what?
Yeah, from the
Void Terror.
From the Melch.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
top deck. Munchkin.
You're like, this is so 2015. Munchkin
like troll you really hard.
But it can like work still really well with Power Overwhelming. Sadly, Firebat played already double Power Overwhelming.
You can just get another one here.
Just getting a third one.
Yeah, 100%. No, 0%.
Can he make the Seeker work? He has 4 minions on board now. Playing the Terror gives you... No, it doesn't give you extra.
Let's tell our viewers. So there's Nedim Cleric Seeker, there's Soulfire, and there's Tournament Attendee as the choice.
Okay, so...
Soulfire seems reasonable, right?
I almost certainly take Soulfire here. Even if you don't play this
it doesn't pick the...
Wow.
It's the Attendee. 2-1 taunt. What do you want to do with this Void Terror, man?
Yeah.
Like,
I
don't want to
eat your 2-1 because it dies a hero power? Oh, interesting. What do you think about maybe playing the 2-1 and just eating all the 1 health minions? That way you have nothing to die to hero power.
I will not mind. Cool. I mean, we have seen double swipe, so I kind of don't feel I am forced to trade them away.
That's a pretty cool... Firebat set that up very smart, too, because he...
Oh,
somehow,
yeah, the 7-7 in and 5-7. That's
seven. Very, very cool.
Oh, a 5 or 4 damage ref here. Can't do that anything?
You can't do much, I think.
I mean, the ref for 2 is still fine on the juggler. You still can combine it with hero power. The only problem is that the 7-7 covers the 5-7 so well.
Yeah.
Maybe Fenrir just... Nah, then... Nah,
I think there's no point. I mean, even if you lose the board somehow... You can just play Yogg next turn, right? So
how about reffing this for 2 and trading scenarios into
the
Night Juggler? I like this more, actually.
You do.
Yeah, we trade the scenarios in the Night Juggler, and it's a 5-5, and it covers the 7-5. I really like it.
There
I really
no
like
silence
it
for the taunt from Zoo. So.
Oh, okay, yeah. For some reason, I thought that you meant trading in the Void Terror here. like trading into the void here. Because I don't like that. Okay, I actually like this. I actually didn't.
Yeah.
I didn't see it at the time, but that's pretty cool.
That's farce and size.
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, that kind of puts you out of the range that it directly dies. And an 8-6 gets a little bit tricky at 12 lives to face.
Yeah, don't have hero power.
Like, Druid has an hero power that deals 1 damage.
Yeah, but 8 damage here. There's no way that's getting hero powered, I think.
Power doesn't solve this riddle yet. You can still trade, but...
Yogg is like...
Yogg is pretty tempting here. I think I would probably wait 1 turn.
Does Force interest his Yogg here?
I think I would wait 1 turn.
Yeah, you can still
you
wait,
can't
I think.
Die.
But your spot is pretty fine, right? I mean,
yeah,
I don't feel in a bad spot.
You get 2 more spells.
You
can
get a
4-3
and a
spell.
Yeah.
And how many spells have we seen? Like
around 10.
Around 10, right? Like 12. 10,
also,
12.
Mulch has been played. The Raven Idol has been played now.
That's true. If you wait too late to Yogg, you can die to burn damage over 2 turns, potentially.
But what do you want to do with Yogg here? You want to attack and play Yogg? Like...
I would trade and play Yogg after, but I can understand going for Fandral as well. Just like
if I was going Yogg, I would Hero Power innervate Yogg first.
Yeah, same.
Yeah.
Getting an Hero Power.
To get 1 more spell.
Wow.
It's a hard one.
And it's actually...
The thing is, I think it's too late to play Yogg. You need to play Yogg earlier in your turn.
Exactly. You can attack with it.
Yeah. Then you get, like, you see that you can attack, but you have just no clue what is going to happen. So you just attack
I don't really mind this. I think this is fine anyways.
I feel you still have a good shot. Yeah. Ooh, wow, double Dark Iron Draft. Not something super... I haven't seen much in Zoom.
Too.
He can... Maybe he didn't have Gormok.
But a lot of extra buffs. Yeah. But well, the double Dark Iron Drop makes a good trade into the Fandral, and now I think it's time.
It's
because this is like a board that... I mean, it's not...
It's your last card, too.
Yeah.
but
not if you pick up like an... Oh.
No, you can't do anything here.
Farsan, you have to do it.
Trade in Yogg? Well, you can Living Roots innervate.
I think I would Living Roots face for the damage.
Do you
because having more mains, it's just going to...
Yeah, even like
it's
attack with the cat,
right?
Right
to your Yogg. Right?
Yeah, makes sense. Like even with the cat attack face.
Do you cat attack face? Yeah.
Cat face, I think.
I will trade the minion.
Okay,
I think.
You don't believe.
Yeah, I know, but I feel if this gets traded, Yogg just has to do 1 thing, and it has to survive or either draw or get secrets.
Yogg always.
Yogg it is then.
Always does something.
Yogg is back.
Oh man.
Okay, this is what Yogg's good card.
You got a dwarf, that's not bad.
Okay.
There's no way this guy survives. There's no way.
Okay, getting like some tokens, really good. Another bear, wow.
Well, even if this dwarf survives,
now it's all good.
2 defensive secrets, super
good. That was a really good Yogg.
Yeah. That was good Yogg.
I mean, it drew a little bit, it gave some secrets, made the boards. Mm-hmm. So everything you kind of want now.
And now you have 8 mana Yogg, even better than 10 mana Yogg.
Yeah. I don't know if he has the balls to play it next turn, though.
Now it can only go wrong. If you're ahead, you generally don't play.
Well, actually, the number of spells is not that terrible. Like, you have enough spells to probably have a good effect out of it.
Yeah, it's just if you need to, right? And at this point, you might just be too far ahead. It depends what Firebat does.
Firebat, the options are kind of limited. You can make this 4-run attack in the 2-2, but do you want it as
2?
Like, you can Forbidden Ritual, get on board again. You can Doomguard, but...
Well, guys, remember the Firebat doesn't know what the secrets are.
Exactly.
Yeah,
so how do you play around the green?
Well,
and
Forbidden Ritual plays perfectly about a counterspell. For the people that don't know, if it is a counterspell, Forbidden Ritual is a 0 mana card, so you remove 0 mana, and he still has the all the mana what he would normally have. So it's
nice.
The perfect answer. I was a bit surprised about it, but when I thought about it, it makes a lot of
sense. Yeah.
It's a 0 mana card. You don't lose any.
Yeah. Because you can't Ritual first on Doomguard. You just want to...
Yeah.
And if you Doomguard, you won't have the Ritual anymore. So
that didn't really work out, the attack in the face, because it only gave armor and a beer on the board.
You have to discard your Plenium at this point. You don't have the life. Does he tap here?
I mean,
I just don't think you ever win if you don't tap.
I don't think you can.
I don't think you ever win anyway.
And that will be it. So Forsen is taking game number 1 with the Druid on the back of Yogg-Saron. So maybe Druid is favored after all.
Well, I think it is.
Never
I think it actually is. Like,
me too.
It comes to a point where Druid is just super super consistent early game, and Drood never had that that kind of consistency.
The Living
early
Roots
game.
Is a huge thing too. Yeah. And if there's any deck that Living Roots is good in, it's Yogg-Druid. Like Living Roots is good in every Druid pretty much, but Living Roots is better in Yogg-Druid than
You get so much synergy with other cards.
So many spells,
but the card is so,
so like
good. Like it's good as a reactive turn one because you kill like a flame imp, and it's good to be proactive and play 2/1s and find some reasonable traits.
I think like almost like Yogg-Druid developed almost because like as Druid gets all these good spells like Living Roots, you're just like more tempted to run Valley Teacher and stuff anyways and Fandral. At that point it's like a full, you know, full yellow.
Like Token Druid had always been around in the early days. Like when there were less cards, it was like Teach or Power of the Wild was a really like together with cards like Holded Creeper.
It was like a tier 2, like slightly worse than a normal Druid, but it was still barely like 5% worse.
The old Druid was also kind of really pretty top tier that it could never shine its way out.
Exactly.
I felt.
I still remember your deck Strifecrow, the real token. Because Token Druid like didn't even have tokens mostly.
I know. I actually remember trying to use what's it called? Imp Master.
Well, we had the ooze at some point, right? Like that you could also buff the
Cedra. So do you like I like turn one Violet Teacher here. Violet Teacher's a 3/5 body, it trades very well into the 1/3.
The only way it dies is to a lightning bolt.
It's very hard to die. Yeah.
It's
yeah.
only lightning bolt.
No, like two spell like double rock
button. And even if even if you lose it, you still have a follow up.
Exactly. You can still just
That hand is awesome.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Really strong hand here.
This is actually a repeat of how I lost to
No, but like it exactly gives the power of the cards. Like Innervate, a super good card in the early game to get like that extra additional mana to make power plays. And Valkgrove is just to grind it up, to like slow it down. So making this power play and then still like making your like access to more mana crystals, really what the Druid just wants. And especially against Aggro Shaman, like you just want to go.
The other play is just nothing sets you up good for any kind of line throughout the next turns, you know?
Yeah.
Like if you coin Wild Growth, you have 3 mana, it's like, nothing's
good. All right, Forsen is going for it, so. And there's no answer for now. There is actually no turn 2 play. Only taunt him up.
Man. That feels bad.
This is not what a Trog wants, man.
No.
Is it a Stoneclaw at least? Nope, not even a Stoneclaw.
Oh, and here the Wild Growth.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, and next turn also the power of the Wild, like if there is not an answer soon.
Yeah, even like Fire Rage is nice.
Well, at least Firebat, like you see the tech here with the Lightning Storm, so can deal well with the tokens.
I mean, even the 1/1 is going to stick around too, probably, so that's even more value from Power of the Wild. Actually, the 1/1 can trade into the Feral Spirits if that happens.
Wow. Oh, wow. Aggressive.
Yeah, he wants
29 to 27. I'm like, is this what we want to do already? Is it already time for the Aggro Shaman?
It's always time to go face.
Yeah,
but time. Obviously the player is down to play face this on turn 4.
Hey, Forsen does not take the... he actually could get Lightning Stormed. He took this trade. I wonder if Forsen knows about Lightning Storm because...
Probably not. I mean, it's the card you don't expect.
This is the better play generally, right? But if you know that they're running Lightning Storm, you can afford to play around it when you're this far ahead, I think.
Well, also...
But you will have made the trade with the 2/2 in the horse
rider. I think if I
100%... I mean, we saw in Trog and a hero power turn 2. Well,
actually,
the horse rider kind of gave it away.
I agree with this play, actually. I'm just... I think I'm dumb. That's not right. Because you can just get Law Burst there, then you have a 2/2.
Yeah.
That can't be.
I like that play, though.
Yeah.
You still keep Lightning Storm for the future. For whatever happens with the tokens, and now you counter this board really well as well. Plus, if Lightning Storm would miss, you still have to use the Rogue Rider.
Red Feral's Rage actually pretty good here, killing off both minions.
Yep.
Or don't you like it?
I like it.
Yeah. No, I was like thinking you can Wrath for one and make one trade.
Yeah, I don't know how you Wrath, but I definitely you have to play both, right?
I mean, Feral Rage. It is a really good. It's actually a pretty good card against Shaman. Like it still trades with Totem Golem as an counter to it.
Like
kind
I could see this cycling here instead of a 2/2.
Kind of makes a little sense with Emperor too. Like you ramped up, you get the Emperor next turn, so the card that you're gonna draw is also already one cheaper.
All right, Firebat just
I think I prefer the for 3 though, because you already have a 6 and 7 for sure, right? I mean, you do get more value.
This hilarious draw here.
But do you really
man.
Need like 2/2s on board?
It's against
this is the
deck.
Worst thing
more
that can actually happen. Like, this was the,
Yeah, where's four firebot? Great for forcing.
That's a lot of taunts.
Yep.
I mean, that's a perfect hand, right? If you had to have, like, if you had to have a small hand at this point as Forsen, you know, this is like a combo deck, right? So it's very hard as a small hand to combo, like Fandral or Power of the Wild, Violet Teacher. But he has three, like, very powerful individual cards. So you can buy time with Ancient Ward and Cenarius, and then you can play Nourish and just combo.
Do you like
from
the
there.
Warrior? I don't like it too much because it doesn't do that well into the 7/7, and you don't get the hero power in the 2/1, where Ezreal does it. And I don't know if the faces can like go face at this point. Like Firebat played it aggressively with the Horse Rider, but still this.
He will still probably go face because at this point you just have to ignore. The longer the game goes, the better for situation for Forsen. And also Firebat has limited resources. Probably no draw in the deck at all. So.
I definitely like Forsen hero powering here and playing a 5 drop.
Doom Hammer draw can be really big, actually.
Yeah, Forsen played really well that, but we were like talking what to do with Firebat, and Firebat has to go face here.
That's that's a lot of damage.
Yeah, it actually goes really fast now. Like,
Lava Burst as well.
Ooh, that looks pretty decent here.
So you can definitely clear.
Do you start by Raven Idling? If you're gonna spend 8 mana, you probably don't Raven Idle. But at some point, you might just want to dig for healing.
So. I mean, we have it costs 0 mana. Yeah, let's just see what spell turn. We draw here.
Okay.
Oh, life.
2 armor.
Ref and Claw also being good.
Yeah, Claw is fine.
2 extra heal. Like, you have to taunt, so the only thing you're scared of is, like, some heavy burn spells at this point.
So, do you prefer Ancient of War or do you prefer Cenarius?
I think I prefer Ancient of War. Because Cenarius is only 2/2 taunts and there's a Doomhammer.
Yeah, so he deals with the taunts.
Yeah, because it dives to the Doomhammer on board, right?
Yeah. Mm.
And this deck will not have hex.
Well, the ref with Living Roots is just so good together. Like, you trade it, you just trade the faces away. And yeah, with that, it just perfectly curves out.
This gives you a much faster
also
call.
An Aggro Shaman just doesn't have an answer for war. Like, people are cutting the Earthshock, or it was already like not being a popular card in the deck. Hexes are still not there for the Aggro Shaman, so.
Well, Rock Biter is an answer, but then you take the
damage. Yeah, well, then you're dying on board, so that's your. That really does for you. So Lightning Storm, well, it looked kind of good as a card in the deck, or in the early games of the stage,
not
but
so good anymore,
he just never find the value of the Lightning Storm.
Yeah.
The older tokens from Fortune just straight a slip away, and now, yeah, the biggies are coming.
I don't know. I almost thought it might be better just to play anything from below, in a way. What do you kill with Lightning Storm?
Yeah, but you don't do anything with it, man. Like, yeah, it feels also
Hero power,
sad.
Thing from below? Maybe Hero power if you get a Spell Power Tome, Lightning Storm, Squire, maybe?
Hero power thing from below, double burn after. I don't know.
I think you can afford to check with hero power right first.
But what do you even want? Like, I feel nothing is relevant, almost. Like, a taunt is, of course, decent. But that's the only one I see, really. I don't... Spell power is not even that appealing. Yeah. You might kill the Emperor,
You might kill both.
Yeah, that's true. You can high roll.
You have to just try to get lucky at this point. With this roll thing from below, right?
Oh, man. Feels so bad.
Can you still win? Not really. Like, if he hero powers, if Forsen does not hero power.
If Forsen plays Yogg next turn, you can still win, maybe.
Is that lethal?
That's lethal.
That's lethal.
Yeah. Like, just talking from Firebat's perspective, but Forsen obviously has lethal scenarios. So Forsen taking second game of Firebat, and Firebat now left with his Druid deck. What is Firebat's Druid?
2 Osa now. Wow.
Yeah, two Osa.
That's long ago, man. That has been long ago.
He's fighting for survival, though.
This is not how I expected the series to turn out. But, you know, Firebat's Yogg Druid. So if Firebat wins him here, and then Yogg Druid always beats aggro.
Isn't it Cthulhu Druid, though?
No.
Okay.
I think so. Because I talked to Firebat about some lineup before.
All right.
And I think it is Yogg Druid.
Yeah.
At least that's Yogg.
Yeah.
So, might
be. Yogg. I mean, if it has Yogg, I'm just going to call it
Yogg. Hey, I play Yogg, Yishar, and Cthulhu in my Estral Druid.
I actually try to put in Yogg in a Cthulhu Druid before. Because, Cthulhu Druid sometimes use Fandral and the idols, anyways. So, why not put Yogg in? I'm not even sure if it's wrong because Yogg is so good.
There is a Sea Giant in the deck. We saw that before.
Yeah, Sea Giant.
And I find it a real interesting tech. It's like it kind of makes some sense, but in another way, it also makes Still no sense as for a me.
Really, really card.
Firebat, basically, I talked to him a little bit about lineups before this tournament. Firebat really predicted very, very heavy aggro lineups like Azun Shaman.
Well, so he's kind of right.
So he was thinking of just putting in Seed Giant in every deck just to fight Zoo. Like even in control, just to, you know, throw a Seed Giant at them. So, you know, if you're going to put a Seed Giant in any weird deck,
hey,
you
thanks
might
for
as
me
well.
Playing so much minions. I got my Seed Giant
exactly.
Now. They Forbidden Ritual.
Exactly.
He just has to play with a Mark of the Wild then or something. Like.
Well, we can get Mark of the Wild from Raven
so
Idol, I guess.
So, instead of Forsen, now Firebat going for the turn one teacher. And you see it here. It's just problematic to deal with.
Yeah, he will have an answer with Feral Rage.
Forsen really fast with the hero power. Gives quite some information away there. It's just no innovative wild growth at all. Breathos, yeah. We're,
So basically setting up for the Feral Rage here.
Now doing do you create a 2-2 and buff the teacher, or do you create a 3-2?
Yeah, well, you say like 2-2 and a plus one is like
3-2
decent.
3-2 makes sense. Like this is more power on
but
board.
You die to
any spell is the same, right, on the Vile Teacher, since Wrath is it'll die anyways, Living Roots will die
yeah,
anyways.
Yeah, it's true.
Far Rage die anyways, so yeah, kind of.
And hey, suddenly there is no play on turn 3 for Firebat. He still has board.
That really hurts in this matchup.
Yeah,
because turn 4 is like kind of the power play normally. Like turn 4, Mindkeeper, Teacher, Vendrell, and you have so much options at 4. And if you have to face a 4 drop, because you cannot develop anything yourself, can really hurt
but
you.
At least he has an answer with the swipe. And now
is that an answer?
That's a pretty bad answer.
That's a super bad answer.
I mean, it is going
I
to
mean, Living
down.
Roots does the same.
Yeah.
And he
well,
for
a, it's going to Feral Rage now that he drew it, but if there's no Feral Rage, Swipe would come down, so you can't leave
You have to kill the teacher.
Yeah, you can't leave with the teacher.
Yeah.
The swipe is also useful like later in the game if the second Violet Teacher comes down. Mm-hmm. And now the Risen Mire Keeper.
Oh, wow. Instantly played from Force in there.
It was so fast it even blocked the Observer mode.
Again, the 2-2 is... Not sure, like, I don't mind the ramp either again. Like, going for the war next turn.
Yeah, Farsen is in a really good spot.
Yeah. Yeah, getting it, like, if there's any power card that you can slam in the mirror, it is Emperor. Not because it discounts you and you are the one playing your big mage first, but
they
also
have
you
it.
Have to kill it. Yeah. And a Druid has to spend his wool turn 6 to make the trade into the Emperor.
Yeah. You always have to kill Emperor. Primo.
Yeah, it's
this is the power of this deck. It's like every minion you have to kill. Vendrell, Vile Teacher, Emperor. It's like
now
every
I think about it.
Is just,
so
you can't leave
if
up.
You sometimes just can't do it, do you just maybe ignore it? But that's also, it's like, it's still too good.
Ignore Emperor? Seriously?
Yeah, if you can. I mean, yeah, if you can, you do. But if
I guess
you, can't, you have to.
Firebat tried to ignore the minion and it didn't work out.
I actually noticed in this matchup that surprisingly, having a high life total is very important because you can play around, like, you have less more leeway in Savage Roar. And also, since Yaga's, like, if you get to late game, Yaga's so good at resetting board states.
Yeah.
But what Yaga doesn't reset is life total.
Yeah,
so
exactly. But it can give you some life, but overall, like,
usually not.
You want to get your opponent really low, so that when he plays his Yaga, he has a chance to kill himself. Same with, like, your Yaga.
Yeah. It's like once you start getting to late game and you're pretty sure they have Yogg and it's starting to be a real consideration, at that point you might even want to do like high, like value your life highly, you know, and maybe less on board, so.
So here, Onyxia on the board for Firebat, and well, it's not easy
no swipe
for,
yet.
Yeah, and like if you think about it, like Onyxia making so much of a comeback now in so much different decks, and it's one of the reasons probably still is BGH being gone as a good removal, but it's if you look at the card 9 mana, look what you get. An 8-8 and so much 1-1s. Like,
I would
you
not
get
call
so
it,
much.
I would not call it a comeback.
Oh, wow.
Because the card was never playable before, right?
Okay, so,
it's like
so you want to say...
I know, like it's a highlight kind of, like the, for the first, it shows
okay.
up for the first
yeah.
time ever.
Firebat has to be relieved that Forsen didn't kill him, right? Because Forsen definitely had outs to just kill him. I mean, with Savage Roar, if... You know, if you had it.
Ooh, this trade is really expensive.
That's a very expensive
trade. Ooh, wow. Why won't we trade this?
Yeah, I think
he has Yogg too. So again, like you, this,
oh,
is,
man.
This is what I was talking about. I think you want to value.
Really backfire. Well, he might know there is a Seed Giant and he's scared of like see Giants for one mana.
But the thing is,
they will still maybe come for one mana with this play.
Yeah, like this is exactly what I was saying though. Because you have Yogg and it resets the board so well, like what sticks around is the life.
So we dealt 18 damage in the minions, right? 11, 15, 18 damage. He could be at 7 now.
Well, but first I had to maybe think about Savage just lethaling him next turn as well. If he left up the 8-8 and those
oh,
two
Oh, yeah, that might
maybe,
be true.
Maybe, like, that's a lot of... He might not get the Yogg. I think he... we didn't do the math, so it's...
Yeah, it's really hard to actually make a decision.
And
like,
he knows there
are
sea giants. I mean, he knows there are sea giants.
But does, yeah, does he still know?
Yeah, I guess so.
Okay.
I saw the series before. Not sure if Forsen was watching, but I hope he did.
Yeah, probably.
I just...
Okay, yeah. So going for the Sejan now, just Farbet, so thinking about his options. 5 mana left for him, right?
Does he ever want to play Sejan first? Well, he's not planning on playing
it. Oh, he doesn't know. Look at the face. He's just, what the hell is this? It's like, what am I facing for Druid? There is a Sejan in
now
there.
Now Forsen's like, maybe I should have
watched
that game.
Maybe I shouldn't have watched the series. So he kind of played around it without knowing it. But that is even better. Like, that's pretty next level. I would say.
Yeah.
Well, if there is one problem for a Druid deck, it is to deal what do you do against single, just single really strong minions.
Yogg's like, around.
Yogg. There we go, I guess.
Well, you can always a Raven Idol for Mulch as well as a possibility.
Yeah, but Yogg gives you it for free, so come on.
Okay.
Yeah, we got a Yogg here, Forsen.
I think it's time.
We got a Yogg here.
I feel like Forsen needs to be more decisive on this
Yogg. Yeah, he just doesn't trust
it,
man. Yeah.
How many spells do you think have been played?
Quite some. He had the double wild. Oh, he had wild
double growth. Wild growth. The second was two spells.
He had also double power up the wild during the game. Oh, you have to be fast, man.
Yeah, you're fast.
Because if there is like an attack with your face and you just don't know what's going to happen.
You can even have minions though. Okay.
All right. He goes for the Yogg. Divine Strength from the giant. Nope. Ice Lance.
Okay.
That's something. Cleave deals damage, maybe execute.
It's a poke.
That's a
what
couple
do we
of
gang
Azure
up? Drakes. Gang up Yogg? No.
No, Azure Drakes are nice as well.
Yoggs are also nice.
To your own face. Oh, you only made it better.
Wow. That was
really bad odds.
Yeah, hey, you summon a 5/5.
Yeah, okay.
You poke the minions a little.
One of them has Divine Shield now, though. Okay. I guess there weren't as many spells as we thought. That didn't seem like that many.
So, there were like 8 spells.
Mm-hmm. 8
spells. There were like a lot of irrelevant stuff, like the... What was it? Shadowward Pain and like a small buff and Divine Shield.
I think with around like 6 to 8 spells, I expect to clear like a wide board of small minions, like, you know, 2 or 3 health. I actually have been playing with Yogg a lot, and if you want to clear bigger minions, like 8/8s, 10/10s, or like C'Thun's, I generally feel like you need around like 12, 15 spells.
Yeah, 12 to 15 is the
To clear like
spot.
Very big minions.
Exactly.
But for a small wide board, like 2/2s, like 8 can do it. So, you know, with 2 big minions here, 8, it's not even that likely that I would clear, to be honest, on the Sea Giant. Maybe.
You idle for...
But normally you will like at least like draw, or get
maybe
a secret, like
something
get
else,
something.
Right? Yeah.
Relevant. Now you only like made your Yogg a bit worse and your opponent minion a bit better.
Well, I mean, after the Yogg gets over, there's no more comeback mechanics after.
Exactly.
To kill this board, so.
Well, there is a possibility of like...
I have seen Deathwings everywhere
Idol.
Lately.
Deathwings from Idol, okay.
Or even like Starfall and Fandral at the same time also is quite nice.
That's a gigantic board. Okay.
Alright, so Firebat is still alive, takes the win in the mirror match, and maybe now we will see the reverse sweep.
How to beat Druid? Just play Druid. Pick your Druid yourself. But I find it really, really cool to see this Druid. Like, it has a little bit around, never really respected, but now people really see the power of what the Druid can do. And yeah, it's just not bad against these aggro decks.
I think this Druid is like the powerhouse of the term. This, I think the two decks that stand out the most to me are the Bog Creeper Shaman.
Yeah,
the control one and
Yogg's
Druid. Yeah.
And Yogg's Druid is also super fun to play because you have this discovery cards from Avian Idol and those interesting turns with Fandral and with Violet Teacher, and obviously Yogg as the sherry on the top.
If there is one mechanic that I think everybody likes playing Hearthstone and also watching Hearthstone, it is the discover mechanic. Like, it gives you different options. As a player, you feel a lot of influences you can do during the play as an Yeah, watch it's also really cool too. I think it's in a really well chosen mechanic.
Every single person I've talked to, from pros to casual players, I don't think I've had one person say they don't like this.
Well, now they're gonna say it just to like trigger you a little bit, but
that doesn't count.
Right, what do you say?
It's time to Raven Idol again at some point.
And Zul versus Yogdruid again. This time the matchup is reversed. Yeah. So we'll
see. This is a bad hand for a Druid. Very bad.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Really slow. Well,
depends what he gets here. Maybe if it gets Innervate.
He gets a Wild Growth.
Sure. It's not even that good anymore.
Yeah, that's still slow, right?
And I mean, you have no turn three, so.
Yeah, I mean, you might as well. Like, Living Roots here maybe would be better.
Yeah,
I'm
but
sure.
you're gonna fall behind the board pretty fast now.
Zul, like, Forsen has an amazing head, actually. Really nice.
Yeah, Imgang Boss is really not the strongest minion against Druid, but can work really well in the early game still. Like, if there are Living Roots around, the Mind Keeper is really not good into an Imgang Boss.
I think one of the strongest things you can do against Druid, though, is to get that Argus on two minions. Because once that happens, it becomes so hard to AoE stuff.
I also feel like Consummon is super strong if you coin it out. Like, it grows already 2 and 3, 5 instantly, and
it trades up
very
easily.
It just starts either trading or it stays there as super strong, and Druid has no access to deal with a 5 HP minion.
Yeah, hard to remove, really. Yeah. Maybe Mulch, but still it's an investment.
Yeah. And the Imgang Boss at the end, it just is 2 damage, and the 4 HP feels a bit irrelevant.
I love Forsen's position here. To set up for the Defender of Argus.
There's like nothing there almost for Farbad. Like, he just can play passive minions. And
He can ramp up still with the Nourish.
But then what do you
get
ramp
the hero
to?
Power. Yeah, you don't really ramp
just
into anything.
8 mana next turn, but then you're leaving up that.
But
whole,
I mean, playing an empty Mind Keeper are teacher.
Everything is.
Yeah, and Forsen has like 12 damage next turn with Defender of Argus. Putting Farbad to 8, and then Farbad will have just one more turn to be able to protect himself.
I mean, you can't realistically draw with Nourish here, right? Or is that possible? I mean, the more I think about it, at some point you just have to YOLO some plays.
What can you even get with Nourish?
Like swipe.
Can swipe even be good with
Swipe Wrath score? Together?
Nourish drawing is just not good.
Yeah, no, it's not good. It's not what you want to do generally, but...
But sometimes there are just no good options, and you have to take the best not good option.
Exactly.
So do you like play... Okay, Mirror Keeper. I was thinking maybe you play one of the key minions, like Thunder or Violet Teacher, because they, in essence, they kind of have taunt.
Well, every minion has taunt against Zul. Like, this is going to die too,
bad.
Right?
Oh, bad. This Defender is so nasty.
Yeah.
I don't know if we really even trade the Imgang Boss. Like, maybe you're scared of like Ezreal Drake Innervate swipe, I would say.
I think you can go face of roll at this moment. You have such an advantage.
Oh man, 11 lives here, so early. Turn 4 of the Zul.
Does Farbad have any outs? It's like...
No, like, I was like, Ezreal Drake Innervate swipe might be something that he can look at, but...
Not anymore.
Just there's not even one piece of it. And the Zul just went into his turn 4 and you put you at 11 lives and
wow.
That's why I think it's so favored.
Well, I think we have seen like a lot of Druids, like the last Druids beating the Zul, but this is still what a Zul can do. Like
Zul is like really consistent and Druid just needs to get
Living
those
wild growth. If he Fandral Raven, Fandral Wrath, he would draw in Lurts, he could have killed 2 minions. Would that have saved him, I wonder?
There's Abusive as well in the hand for Forsen, so I doubt it.
He could have killed the wolf and the Imp. I don't know, I mean, it still probably lose, but... almost.
You gotta take the best option in that situation.
I think that was still wrong to Nurse I believe he did.
And that will be it, so Forsen has it with 12 damage here.
Does he have it?
Yeah, he has like 12 from with Abusive and even with Jugglers a bit more.
Yeah, it's...
So, wow, Forsen doing it here. 14 Forsen, boys. Yeah. Also for...
Eliminating Firebat in the tournament. So...
Must feel really happy for Forsen to not go like 0-2 or 0-4 again and take a year to win.
Feels bad for Firebat and Strifecore, I guess.
Yeah.
But Cloud9 still has ECOP in the tournament. Yes. He advanced to 33.
First place too in this group.
Representing. All right. So we have Forsen coming to us. He was casting many series. He was preparing for this tournament for 30 minutes total. So, Forsen, with all the preparation you've put, which is like 30 minutes or like maybe up to 2 hours. No? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
A bit louder.
Sure.
Yeah, thanks.
Can you put a headset maybe, actually? Do we have a headset for you?
No, I'm good.
Okay, perfect. Mm. So congratulations first.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
You're still alive in the tournament. Mm. And then now you will have a chance to continue fighting versus either Sixo or Eloise. Who do you want to face?
I mean, Sixo is obviously the stronger player, so I'd rather face Eloise.
All right, so you don't want to have a challenge?
I mean, the challenge will come later.
Eloise is a challenge.
Yeah. Everything is a challenge right now, dude. 140 IQ is the beat. Uh-huh. Fireban.
Yeah. Did you expect Drew to perform this well?
I mean, I expected to beat Eloise more than I expected to beat Firebat. So, but yeah, I didn't play really good in the first series. And I did even make some misplays versus Firebat. I know that. But I mean, the more I play, like, this is probably as many games as I played this last month, you know? So the more games I play, the better it will go.
So you're becoming a better and better player with every match
every
you play
game,
here.
Yeah. Every game, I'm like, oh yeah, that's right. You should do that, not that. Oh yeah.
It's like the practice game.
Yeah, the practice games. All right, guys. Do you have any questions for Forsen?
No, I'm good.
No, not really. Like,
I should have watched their match though. I had no idea they played Sea Giant and Druid.
Yeah,
I really
but
surprised.
I was played like the series before, like sometimes. But,
yeah, I didn't watch that, so I was like, yeah, fuck.
So one last question. Do you have any words for your next opponent, whoever it is?
Huh? Supporters?
No, like, do you have any words for your next opponent?
Oh, my next opponent? I don't know who that is.
That, it doesn't matter.
I mean, not really, dude.
Okay, no words?
No.
All right, that will be it then. So, guys, we still have a couple more matches for you. The group is still going on, so we'll be back after a break.